I, Shubham Kumar Chaubey and Shubham Jha from CSEB second year have made a full stack JavaScript web application called Clarifier. Now, there may be questions why we have selected web applications. The reason is very simple. Users having internet connections can join us very easily. It usually runs through web browsers like Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, and so on. Now, let's come to our topic. The internet is a huge resource of knowledge and information where we can find virtually anything. But very often there are situations where we aren't able to find the answers to our questions. This is a simple question answer forum website where users can post their questions and other users can answer it accordingly. It is somewhat similar to Quora, Stack Overflow, Ask Relay, and so on.
Next slide, please. Now, following tools have been used to develop this project. First of all, React JavaScript, CSS3, Redux, Figma for UI developing, for UI designing, Firebase, and Hero for developing our app. Let's talk about all of these in a bit more details. So first, let's talk about React JavaScript. React JavaScript is a library for building user interface. React is used to build single page applications. React allows us to create reusable UI components. Now let's move upon Redux. Redux itself is a standalone library that can be used with any UI layer or framework. Although Redux and React are commonly used together, they are independent of each other. It helps us in writing applications that behave consistently, run in different environments, and are easy to test. Now, thereafter comes user interface. Further will be explained by my partner Shubham Jha.
Okay, sir. So now the next slide is user interface. So for the user interface, sir, we haven't used any CSS library, just to make things a bit simpler. However, we have used a very powerful and fast tool that is known as Figma for designing the prototype of our application. So now here comes the main thing, that is the backend of this application. Rather, I should say backend as a service. Firebase is a platform developed by Google for creating and mobile web applications for the growth of our apps. Rather, I should say a tool set to build, improve, and grow our applications. It provides a tons of tools like analytics, user authentication, real-time database, configuration, file storage, push messaging, and the list goes on. The benefit of using Firebase is that the developer efforts get reduced very easily. We are more focused towards the development of the client-side code rather than focusing on the backends. This is fully maintained and operated by Google, and it lets us to directly write our client app, and we don't need to establish any middleware between our app and the backend. So now this is by making use of Firebase, this is way more different than the traditional web app development. In the traditional full stack development, we have to write both front end and back end on our own. The front end code just invokes the API endpoints exposed by the back end, and the back end actually does the work. We have to write code for both. But however, the platforms like the services like Firebase, we don't have to indulge much on the backend code. We can only shift on the client side. Firebase provides a tons of applications like user authentication, database, which we had to do manually earlier. But now these things are directly provided by Firebase. That's why we have used Firebase for this project, as it reduces the developer effort very much. So now it's time to demonstrate our application, sir. So let me exit the presentation mode. So as you can see, my localhost server is up and running. We haven't deployed our app yet, but we will soon deploy. Just a minute. So I'm opening a new tab, and on that I'm typing localhost 3000. It's running on the port 3000. And just a minute, yes, you can see the home page here. We have nailed our app Clarify, which means all your doubts will get clarified hassle-free, just like we do daily in our day-to-day life in like Stack Overflow, Quora, etc. So allow me to register a new user. I will just simply write johndoe@gmail.com. This is nothing but a test user, and for the password I am just writing 123456. Now I am clicking on the register button since it is registering for the first time. Now after registering, we come to the dashboard page. On the right side, we just have made our watermark that this project is developed by me and my friend. In the navigation bar, there is a button called Ask the Question, and currently the post feed is empty. So now I am going to ask a question. Let me ask a question, just a dummy question. Should I learn PHP in 2021? And now I am clicking on this add question button. So this will post the question in the feed. So just when I click the post button, it is now showing in the feed that this question is asked by johndoe@gmail.com. The question is, should I learn PHP in 2021? And it's saying the date and the timestamp. So now I have to answer this question. For that, I have to create another user. So I will first log out from this account. So I have successfully logged out from this account, and now I will create another user. I am creating a user test01@gmail.com, and again for this password I am writing some dummy password, as these are just for testing. So now, as you can see here in the top section, that is the have a doubt section, here now the email is showing test01, which means that this account is now logged in with test01. And in my feed, it's showing that John Doe has asked a question, that should I learn PHP in 2021? So now, if I am the expert of this domain, the test user is expert, so I can answer this. So allow me to answer this question. I am clicking on the answer button here, and you can see here it is written by, the question is written here, and it is written this is asked by John Doe on 4th of April on 6:49 p.m. So I am writing some just for dummy answer. Yes, definitely you should learn PHP. Definitely you should learn PHP. And just like, let's keep the answer simple. And now I am going to post the answer. So the answer is posted here. The answer. Even if I refresh my application, the answer still stays here, because it's now going to the real-time database and it's coming directly from the database. Just to make things a bit more sure, I am creating another one more user, test02@gmail.com. Now there is a third user known as test02. Once the test02 logs in, even he can see in his feed that there is a question asked by John Doe, and that question is already answered by a user called test01. And if the test02 wants, he can also add another answer that no, please don't learn PHP. Please don't learn PHP. It is outdated. So in this way, there can be multiple users and there can be discussions can be continued, and the app goes on this way. So if I go to my Firebase console, I have already created the project that is known as question answer. And if I go to the authentication part, I can see that there are currently three users registered in this application. The first one was John Doe, second one was test01, and the third was test02. And if I go to my Firebase database, there I can see there are multiple documents. Of course, Firebase provides a NoSQL database. Here, SQL is not used. So in the NoSQL database, I can see there are the documents available. A question was asked, should I learn PHP? This was asked by the user John Doe, and it has a connection field known as answer. And if I click the field answer, I can see that there are again two further documents, that is, there were two answers actually. The first answer The first answer is the most recent one. The answer by test 02, that is please don't learn. And first answer was the old answer answered by test 01, that yes, definitely you should learn. So in this way the discussions can be continued for having multiple users online. And so we have tried to clone something like Quora or Stack Overflow in a very short way. And let's go back to the presentation. So this was all about the app demonstration, sir. And this was a login page. So since this is the initial work by starting of a project, there are multiple scope of improvements in it. Now the following lines shows that what we can do to improve. First of all, we will try to allow users to upload images as well, because having image upload, we can easily increase the readability. Then we will make the profiles of each user. Each user will have profile and it will increase the chances of connecting different users. Then we will make questions category wise. For example, all the technology related questions will be in the tech category. All the health related issues will be in the healthcare category, and so on. Then again, we will try to implement that every answer feature should have an upvote or downvote. For example, if I go to the application here, the application is currently logged by the user test 02. He can see that there is an answer, please don't learn PHP. So if he feels that this answer is not appropriate, he can upvote or downvote. These features, however, not implemented right now, but we will surely implement it in future. These are the scope of improvements for our app. And finally, we will try to provide multi-language support, because it will then increase, then our app will cover a wide range. And so the entire code of the application is open source and is available on my GitHub repository. So with this, sir, we come to the end of our presentation. So I hope you like this. Now we would request your views on it.
Yeah, excellent. I think can any of you turn camera, then it will be great enough. Yeah. So